The half-life of radium-226 is 1,590 years. If a sample contains 100 milligrams, how many milligrams will remain after 2,500 years? To model this exponential decay, we have the option of using this exponential function here or this exponential function here. So let's talk about the differences. In this function, p of t is the amount after time t, a is the initial amount, b is the base equal to 1 plus r, where r is the decay rate per unit of time, and t is time. In this exponential function here, p of t is the amount after time t, p sub 0 is the initial amount, and k is the continuous exponential decay rate, and t is time. So the biggest difference is, here k is a continuous decay rate, and here r is the decay rate per unit of time. And for this problem, since we're not asked to determine the decay rate or continuous decay rate, it doesn't matter which function we use. So for this example, we're going to use this first exponential function here. If you want to see an example dealing with half-life using this exponential function, I'll put a link on the screen. So looking back at our problem, if the half-life of radium-226 is 1,590 years, if A is the initial amount, that means that P of 1,590 must equal 1/2 times A. So to get the amount remaining after 1,590 years, we have to multiply 1/2 and A, which means our function P of T would be equal to the initial amount A times 1/2
when T is equal to 1,590.
So if we make this exponent here T divided by 1,590, notice that when T is 1,590, the exponent would be equal to 1, and therefore the function value would be 1/2 a. So this exponential function will model the decay of radium-226. So to answer the question, if a sample contains 100 milligrams, how many milligrams will remain after 2,500 years? So we need to evaluate P of 2,500, and the initial amount, or a, is equal to 100, and the time is 2,500, so the exponent is 2,500 divided by 1,590. This function value will tell us how much remains after 2,500 years. So now we'll go to the calculator. So we'll have 100 times 1/2 in parentheses, raised to the power of 2,500 divided by 1,590 in parentheses. So we can see approximately 33.6 milligrams remain after 2,500 years. Again, I do want to point out that we could have obtained the same result using this function here, though I believe it would have taken more work.